I had graduated from college with a journalism degree and law school and begun writing shortly after graduation. So I was pretty young. I was in my late 20s, which back then was extraordinarily unusual for a children's book writer. And more recently, you see many more younger writers, but that wasn't true at the time. And I had been clerking at the Office of the General Counsel for the Department of Health and Human Services in Chicago, had decided in the wake of the Oklahoma City bombing that I wanted to do something I felt was a more heartfelt contribution to the world. And so I relocated from Chicago to Austin because it was more affordable and began working at St. Edward's University to help pay bills. And I was a tutor in English for a program that served students from migrant farm families who were freshmen enrolled. I loved it. It was a terrific job. It was as much big sister as it was English tutor composition. And between students, I was thinking about the stories they were telling me and the family they were missing and what it was like growing up. I had just started really thinking seriously about writing for children. I was very much in my apprenticeship. I was reading and reading, and I was reading as many contemporary children's books as I could find with native content. And there were very few. Joe Bruchak had published a few in the late 1990s that really stood out. And it occurred to me that the vast majority of them featured male protagonists, boys and men. There was this idea, especially with secondary characters. You would have this white boy who was for some reason lost in the wilderness, but it was okay because he had run into this native person who could guide him through whatever was to come, which seemed a little ridiculous to me, especially then because I couldn't find my car in the college parking lot. And the idea that we had this magical compass by virtue of our indigenousness just made no sense whatsoever. So I was trying for something that was more authentic, but also something that would speak to a larger experience than that boy adventure genre tradition in children's literature. And so I was thinking about jingle dancing, because it is a dance that is traditionally passed from women to girls. Increasingly two-spirit Native people are also jingle dancing. And it's a very popular dance. It was originated with the Ojibwe people, Anishinaabe people, but it spread across the continent. And it seemed like a wonderful way to touch on reciprocity, to touch on intergenerational relationships, and to craft something that was very modern day. The original draft was scribbled on the back of a torn envelope. It was actually a sister's story initially, and that element fell away completely over time and became more of a hybrid story and concept book around the number four as a structure.